I'm Matt Beecher, and I'm at the La Quinta Resort and Club in Palm Springs for REITWISE 2017, Nareit's Law, Accounting, and Finance Conference. Joining me today is Catherine Ide, Senior Director of Professional Practice with the Center for Audit Quality. Catherine, thanks so much for joining us.
It's good to see you, Matt.
Now, can you start by giving us an overall view of what CAQ's mission is?
If you think back to the early 2000s when for better or for worse, WorldCom became a household name, Enron became a household name. There was a loss of confidence in the capital markets. In 2007, the CAQ was set up with a mission of enhancing investor confidence and public trust in the capital markets. And we do that in several ways. We foster high quality performance by public company auditors. We convene and collaborate appropriate stakeholders to advance critical issues that require action or intervention. And we also advocate for rules and standards that promote high quality performance of those public company auditors and emphasize the independence, objectivity, and responsiveness of the auditors to the dynamic market conditions.
Now, the topic of non-GAAP measures has been top of mind at the SEC over the past year. In December, the CAQ published its thoughts on the topic. What were the key takeaways from that document, and what should management and audit committees be doing right now?
Regulators have been focused on information that companies present either through press releases or earnings calls, basically information that is outside of the financial statements that get filed with the SEC. And at the same time, companies are having an internal debate about what information they can provide to investors that is relevant, reliable, and timely. Now, non-GAAP financial information, when used appropriately, provides useful insights about companies. And our document that was released in December, continuing the conversation, calls for just that, a conversation among the financial reporting supply chain members to determine the appropriateness of the presentation, preparation, and use of this information. And we believe that the auditing profession is uniquely positioned to foster this dialogue because we have a lens into kind of many facets of those stakeholders in this process. And we can help in that dialogue to enhance public trust in those measures. And then we also released last summer a tool for audit committees that basically outlined questions for them to consider as they consider their own company's non-GAAP financial measures and their transparency, consistency, and comparability, as well as understanding the disclosure controls and processes within their companies that those measures were being developed under.
And lastly, the PCAOB has put forth a number of proposals over the past few years that impact how audits are conducted and how audit results are communicated. What are the near-term standards that will be effective, and how do you see them impacting public companies, including public REITs?
The CAQ has been very supportive of the PCAOB's responsiveness to calls from investors and other financial statement users to increase the transparency around the audit process. The first and foremost of these standards is the auditor's reporting model. Now, just to provide some context here, the auditor's report has not really changed in about 75 years. So the PCAOB had issued several proposals over the past few years providing their perspective on what should be enhanced in the auditor's report to provide more transparency. We have provided extensive input on, we at the CAQ have provided input on those proposals to ensure that the ultimate standard is operational in practice. Now, there hasn't been any formal rulemaking or advancement of that proposal at the PCAOB, and I think we can look to the new administration in terms of transition. There are several nominees that are outstanding for the SEC chair, which oversees the PCAOB, so I think we're kind of in a wait-and-see type of pattern related to the auditor's reporting model. Now, there is another rule that is under this transparency umbrella that was indeed approved, and it's actually part of that rule is in effect right now. So this is a rule related to the disclosure of auditing participants in the audit itself. Again, under the umbrella of providing financial statement users information about the roles and responsibility of the auditors. So for audit reports issued after January 31st of this year, auditors were required to disclose the engagement partner name in a database that is resident on the PCAOB website. So I think at last check, probably a week ago, there are about 3,000 of those, and we would expect those to increase as more and more companies, auditors issue their reports on calendar year-end companies. The second part of that rule goes into effect June 30. So for audit reports issued after June 30 of this year, the auditors are required to disclose certain other accounting firms that participated in the audit and disclose the percentage or range as it relates to total audit hours. So we have that to look forward to, or auditors have that to look forward to this summer.
Catherine, thank you so much for joining us.
No problem.
For more from REITWise 2017, be sure to visit NAREITsREIT.com.